We now started for examination of jugular venous pressure. That is important for everyone studying medicine. Here we have to do the bed at 40 degrees. This is the 90 degree and this is the 45 degree. 45 degree here. You can relax here. Yes. And the burst, we have made to make this muscle relax to watch the jugular venous pressure internal. Here is the internal jugular venous pressure wave and pressure. The sternocleidomastoid muscle is extended from mastoid bruises here, look, up to sternal angle. This is the first head. The second head from the clavicle up to mastoid bruises also, two heads. Between these heads, look, the wave, two waves, like this. Two waves. This is the characteristic of internal jugular venous waves. Two waves, double. That is differentiate the jugular venous from the carotid, which is only single wave. And we have to differentiate because the convulsion arises due to the external enlargement of external jugular vein that containing valves. The valves, the presence of valves, do not measure. Permit us to measure the pressure of right atrium directly. But the internal jugular vein is not containing valves, so that we used internal jugular vein to measure the right atrial pressure by using the roller from the sternal angle of Lewis here. Like this, we use the roller, and then we make a perpendicular or transverse connection between the internal jugular vein pulsation and the roller. A normal person only just elevated above the clavicle up to 3 centimeters, a normal person. But abnormally, it is elevated more than four centimeters above the clavicle and sustained. Here, two pulsation. Look carefully and shine the light to the pulsation. If we don't obtain the pulsation, we have to press above the abdomen. We don't press above the liver because the liver is tender in this case. Look the pulsation here. All of this area. Double pulsation. Please keep it in your mind. Double pulsation, what is named A and V wave. Look at the ECG of this patient. There is a sinus rhythm here. If no sinus rhythm is present, there is absent of a wave. But sometimes, due to presence of premature ventricular beat, there is dissociation between atria and ventricle, so that the cannon wave appear here. This is the abdominal jugular reflex for 5 to 10 seconds. 5 to 10 seconds from the angle of Lewis, because the right atrium is below this angle of Lewis, about 5 centimeters. And if we obtain the jugular venous pressure above this by 4 centimeters, it is 9 centimeters mercury or 9 centimeters water. That is the normal. But in this patient, it is an abnormal pulsation. How can we differentiate the jugular venous pressure from the carotid? By pressing here above the jugular disappear. But the carotid is not disappear. And double pulsation in jugular venous, but the carotid is only single. And the venous pressure, it's changeable during the movement of the patient. It is changeable. Look, here it's changing, absent, or barely seen here above the clavicle. But the carotid is still. And by deviation, the jugular venous pressure is changeable also. And not palpable, similar to the carotid pulse. What is the condition in which the jugular venous pressure is increased? Here, any disease that affected the right ventricle is causing, and right atrium is causing right jugular venous pressure to increase. Why we measure it from the right side? Because the right side is directed to the right atrium. And what is the condition which causing decrease the jugular venous pressure? Mainly the hypovolemia. How can we differentiate between the internal mediastinal obstruction due to tumor or thrombosis of superior vena cava or trauma or any obstruction. The obstruction outside of the heart cause no pulsation, pulseless, non-pulse time. Non-pulse time, jugular venous pressure is caused by mediastinal obstruction. But in case of pulsation, is related to the right atrium and right ventricle. And in case of constrictive pericarditis with the prominent of descent Y and days of the pericardial tamponade. This maybe it is enough for the medical student. Thank you for your listening.